Arre vah. People have already started saying hi. So as usual, it is Friday and I'm back on the live feed. This is my favorite day of the week because I get to speak to you guys. Yaar, pure hafte mein ek din milta hai when I get to talk to you one-on-one. And it's like such a nice experience, you know, to, you know, see what's on your mind and just to say hi to everybody. And this is the Stay Uncle Crib, and it is me, Dikshi Auntie, as usual, back on the scene, back on the other side of the screen. And I just want to say hello and namaste to all of my friends on the other side of the screen. Piyush Sharma is saying, hi, I'm here. Hi, I'm here too. Hi. Ajay Singh, hi Ajay, nice hair color. Ooh, thank you, I like it too. Sudhir Alawat is saying hi. Ajay Kumar is saying hi. Ajay Kumar is saying, yes, it's Friday again. Yeah, it is Friday again and I'm back as usual. This is really my favorite time of the day. Main sare office mein logon ko bol deti hu, bas ab sab chup ho jao. It's time for my live feed, it's time for me to talk, and it's time for you all to shut up. So, मैं वहां जाती हूँ और मैं सबको बोलती हूँ क्लोज द ब्लडी डोर एंड टॉक सॉफ्टली बिकॉज़ आई वांट टू बी एबल टू टॉक टू माय पीपल, यू नो. माधव कुमार सिंह, हाय, आई लव यू मैम, आई लव यू टू. माधव कुमार, थैंक यू. सो आई एम हियर फ्रॉम न्यू दिल्ली एज यूजुअल. दिस इज वेयर वी आर हेडक्वार्टर्ड, द कैपिटल सिटी, द सिटी ऑफ कॉन्ट्रोवर्सीज, द सिटी ऑफ ग्रीनरी एंड द सिटी ऑफ टेंडरी चिकन. माय गॉड, इट्स माय फेवरेट. यस, द पंजाबी दैट आई एम. Well, this is, you know, I'm from Sanchit's room. I'm, you know, this is the office, Sanchit's office that I'm speaking from today. And I have so many interesting updates for you. My God, I'm like totally excited. And let's see, who else is saying what? Sabse pehle batao, where are you guys messaging from? I want to know which part of the country you guys like message me from. Yeah, like I want to know, like, see, I'm here from Delhi. तुम लोग कहां से हो बताओ, जल्दी से बताओ, जल्दी से बताओ. ओके, लेट्स सी. अजय कुमार सिंह, स्टे अंकल जिंदाबाद. ओके, अजय धीमन इज फ्रॉम गुड़गांव, थैंक यू. पीयूष शर्मा, आई एक्चुअली सेट अ रिमाइंडर फॉर एवरी 5 PM फ्राइडे. रियली, हाउ स्वीट ऑफ यू, थैंक यू मैम, थैंक यू, धन्यवाद. असीम सिद्दीकी इज फ्रॉम साउथ दिल्ली, दैट इज कूल मैन, वी आर इन साउथ दिल्ली एज वेल. चिरागी सिंह, क्या आपने आधार कार्ड पैन कार्ड से लिंक करवाया है? हमने करवा लिया है, हमने सब कुछ करवा लिया, आप चिंता ना करें. माधव कुमार सिंह, हाउ यू कैन हैंडल आवर प्राइवेसी. अरे बाप रे, क्वेश्चन आने शुरू हो गए, रुक जाओ यार, अभी जरा हाय हेलो करने दो, दो मिनट. ओके, वेरी नाइस. Who else is saying? Piyush is saying, you're looking marvelous. Oh, thank you. I'm sure you're looking marvelous too, Piyush. Okay. So, first and foremost, the big announcement is that the website is launched. The new website is launched. I mean, it is Stay Uncle. But as you can see, the branding is changed. The color is changed. It's a very pretty, pretty pink now because I love pink. And no, this wasn't changed because I like pink. This was changed because pink is the color of love. So, well, that's why. You can go to the website and navigate yourself. It's a very easy and easy to work sort of a website with. All the hotels, the featured hotels are there. All the search, you know, hotels that you want to search are there. My photograph is also there. In case you want to like log in to, you know, to get through the dating course, because I have made a dating course which is available on Stay Uncle TV. And if you singles want to just sort of get your skills, you know, brushed up again, just go to that course and then you can, you know, it's a 5-part series. So I've given like a series of videos over there. So if you have any questions, you can just email me. My email is mentioned as well. So yes, have you downloaded the app? By the way, the app is available on the Play Store, the Google Play Store, and the iOS Play Store as well. So please go and download it, man. Time of waste karo, download karo. Weekend is close. To all the regular customers, your discounts keep rolling out to you. To the people who are new and have not tried the service, try the service and then you will know what it's like. And yeah, it's good fun, man. Weekend is around the corner and, you know, Valentine's like is also around the corner now. I know many of you don't believe in this whole Valentine's sort of a thing, but you know, it's kind of fun. Maybe instead of celebrating Valentine's like this one day sort of a thing, you can remember Valentine's as, you know, something that you can do for your loved one all year round. You know, why just wait for one day? But you know, since Valentine's is here, so why not make the most of it? So let's see. I have heard that there is no attendance. Yeah, Asim Siddiqui, yes. Basically what he's saying is that in, you know, like my two of my great founders, they have they came up with this idea that, you know, actually Sanchit uncle came up with this idea that, hey man, people don't need to come every day to work. You can work from anywhere you want, but work has to be done. So now we can practically work from anywhere in the country. So we don't have to like come to work every single day, you know, aa jao 10 baje to ghar koi nahi aata, 11 baje aate hain sare. But still, you know, you come at, like, if you want to come to office, the office is always open. If you don't want to come to office, you work out of anywhere, which means I can work out of Chennai, which means I can work out of Shimla, which means I can work out of my home as well. Wow, this is just awesome. So yes, Asim Siddiqui, this is a very, very progressive step that my bosses have taken. And Blaze Uncle wrote a really, really interesting article on this. If you're on LinkedIn, you must go to LinkedIn and check out the StayUncle profile. And there's an article there which he's written, and it's beautifully written. And I really recommend you go read it. Anurag Singh is saying, look fab in redhead. Thank you. Mujhe bhi actually lal pasand hai. Anyway. So today I'm going to be taking some more questions. As you know that, you know, coming towards the Valentine week, I have been addressing relationship-based questions because, look, I understand that Valentine's is all beautiful and fun, but we also have to remember, you know, there are certain real things, real problems that people face. And some people don't have, you know, like a best friend to go and talk to or someone they can confide in. So you can come confide in me and you can write to me as well. My email address is dikshi-auntie@stayuncle.com. Speak to me there and I will get back to you shortly. As a matter of fact, some people did write to me a few days ago and I kind of forgot to respond because I sort of fell ill in the middle. So I was just recovering and today I've sent out the responses to all the people who have written to me. Let's see. Okay, Anurag Singh says, you look like my ex. Is that a good thing or a bad thing? I'm sorry if I do, man. It was totally unintentional. But Saeed is saying, looking young day by day. You are looking hot. Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Have you guys done something about anti-Valentine community who just beat up the couple on Valentine? Sweetheart, Piyush Sharma. Sometimes the anti of, you know, all these people who are anti-Valentine, you know, brigade is to really not do anything. It is not to react, but it is to continue what you are doing, because not reacting badly is also a response. It means that it doesn't bother you at all. Let them do what they have to do. You will not stop doing what you are doing. So yes. So I'm going to start taking my questions now. So this is our, so I have these anonymous people who write to me, and some of them are not anonymous, but I don't take their names. So here's the first question. This is a woman, I'm assuming she's a woman in either her early 30s or late 20s. She says, my partner is 7 years younger. I'm wondering whether it's workable between us. So, okay, this is actually breaking conventions, to be honest. If you are, miss, if you are in your late 20s or perhaps early 30s, and, you know, you are with someone who you are mentally syncing with, and even if he's 7 years younger, it's a pretty real, you know, scary situation to be with someone who's that age and, Normally, it's always acceptable when a man is with a woman who is that many years younger, right? But when you see like a woman with a younger guy, it's like, pehle to sare, all the guys around are like, ooh, older woman, ooh, wow. Like, you know, there is this thing. But if it's a real relationship, my suggestion to you is, really practical suggestion is that you need to just see if the guy is, will he be able to stand up to that resistance? So that is something that you need to see. If he is someone you think will be able to stand up for you and for this relationship, then you can absolutely carry on. I understand that sometimes there are people in your lives you meet and you feel like, this is the guy, you know, this is the guy for me and everything matches. But, you know, we are in India and families are like, being in family is like such a huge thing. So a lot of people are not able to stand up to their family, especially guys. So take a call. If you think that he'll be able to stand up for you eventually, because that day will come. It will come. And if he doesn't have it in him to stand up for you, then just move on to the next, like, I mean, just like, take a call. I don't think it's a great idea to linger on, to be honest, because a relationship moves with two people. So, you know, I hope this sort of sorts out your question. Let's see. Antariksh bolo 10 marks ka answer de rahe ho aunty. Thank you. Listen, you guys have to please give in your inputs as well, because it's just not me who's like has been in relationships, but all of you are in relationships and all of you have different like different experiences as well, and I don't want just to be me who's just talking. So why don't you guys also give your two cents and let me see what you have to say about this, you know. Good response is a good response. Hi Dikshi Auntie, good to see you. I was occupied last week, could not make it to this live feed, but this time I made it a point. Looks like I'm getting addicted to this. But this addiction is good and sometimes very informative. I really salute this forum that StayUncle is not only promoting your brand but also contributing so much to the society by discussing many things which were not discussed so openly before. Way to go, StayUncle. Thank you, Madmas Bindas. That is my responsibility here as a community builder. It is to talk about things that people are generally uncomfortable to talk about, that we don't address. We do have, you know, people who want to talk about relationships. Last time we had someone who wanted to know what is the correct age to have sex. You know, I have more questions where, you know, real situations will be discussed. So thank you so much, Madmas, and please keep coming to the live feed. And please contribute in any way you can, and get your friends to the live feed as well. That'll be great. Antariksh is saying, no, auntie, I'm not into a relationship. Kudi kendi pehle jagar lelo. Us kudi ko bolo jao, pehle bahar chali jao. Yeah. So, right. So that should not be your criteria for, you know, getting into a relationship. Anyway, so I'll take my next question now. Right. So before that, I have someone who's saying something. My girlfriend starts behaving weird. She gets angry on every minor thing, and she doesn't talk to me much now. When I ask her that if she still loves me or not, she always replies yes. Okay, so you need to tell me, Piyush, how long has your relationship been? How long have you been dating this girl? And she doesn't talk to me much now. So she doesn't talk to me much now is something that is on a daily basis or in your general conversation? Or is it when you ask her what's the problem, then she doesn't tell you? Give me a few more details and I'm going to address this in this very feed itself. Okay, so how long has your relationship been, and her not talking to you, is it something that is on a daily basis? Obviously, if this is happening, there is some sort of communication lapse that is happening between the two of you, and you need to not just introspect what is happening with her, you need to introspect as to if the communication is not able to happen, Is it something that you are doing? Are you being approachable? Do you have weird reactions? Do you get angry very fast? Is it that she's afraid to tell you why she's angry because she's afraid how you will react? So these are some of the things that you need to sort of figure out. But just give me these details and we'll get on forward from there. Okay, Piyush is saying 1 year. So you've been dating for 1 year, this girl. All right. So here are a few things, Piyush. In normally in any long-term relationship, there is always a phase where both people are angry with each other. And this is the adjustment phase where she's sort of, you know, the honeymoon period of 6 months of being in love is, you know, sort of over. And you sort of get to each other's realities of, hey, like he tells me he'll call back, then he doesn't call back. Or, you know, he's always out with his guy friends. Or, you know, that phase starts where you discover things about her eventually and she discovers things about you. And then you're like, what is this? So that's when the friction starts. But I think this sort of friction is also good because once the friction starts, then you sort of settle in with each other. So you need to be very calm and be very polite and be very approachable to her and find out and tell her. Express yourself. Don't get pissed off on her. Don't accuse her of anything. Don't blame her for anything. Just tell her, this is what I'm observing. And this is what I feel, that you don't talk to me and you're just pissed with me all the time. Is there something that you'd like to tell me or is something bothering you? So that maybe it is something changeable, then I will change. And then we'll see. Or maybe if I'm oblivious that I'm doing something and I don't know that I'm doing something wrong and I'm just continuously doing it. But for that to stop, you need to tell me. So just, you need to talk. The only way through this is to talk and please communicate, Piyush. And if still in such a scenario, if she still doesn't respond to you, if she's still not talking to you and is still not communicating, then just my suggestion would be to just take a step back and just sort of sleep on it for a while and observe. Just observe whether is this a phase. Is it going out or is this continuing? You know, ki ek saal se der saal nikal gaya aur wohi cheez chal rahi hai, you know, ya do saal nikal gaya aur wohi cheez chal rahi hai. So, you know, this is something you'll have to see. I hope I have addressed your question. In case you still have more questions, Piyush, you can always email me. I'm available and I'm the one who answers the emails. So, you know, you don't have to worry at all. Hi Ayushi, how are you? Thank you for joining the feed. She's saying that I met a guy on a dating site and we have planned to get married this year. Wow, that's great. Congratulations. Is this something you both have come up to? Like you both are like, you know, have come up to do this or you are thinking or what is it to tell me? And please tell me when is the date and am I invited? Okay, Himanshu Sharma is saying, what do you think about people on dating sites? Are they good enough for a long-term relationship? I love this subject. Dating sites, OkCupid, Tinder, all of this is actually my favorite subject. Now I'll tell you something about dating sites is, you'll find all sorts of people on dating sites, Himanshu. There is a huge chunk of people who are just there to hook up. Okay, that is one reality. But in all of that huge bunch of people, you might find someone who is looking for a long-term relationship as well. So I won't say that you only find people who are looking for relationships and you don't only find people who are looking for hookups. However, there are certain kind of, because you're a guy, there are certain kinds of women which you should avoid on dating websites. And it will just help you not waste your time because from your question, it seems like you are someone who's looking for like a little more meaningful, you know, relationship, you know, or something that leads to a meaningful relationship. Now on StayUncle TV, I have put up another, what I'll do is I'll post this link specifically on your comment, Himanshu, where I have taken out a Facebook a YouTube video, which talks about, you know, what kind of women you should avoid when you are when you're on these dating apps. And if you just go through a few of these points that I have given, it will help you to not waste your time. Like women who, you know, the Instagram followers, the catfishers, and all sorts of these kind of people. So I will post that link to you, Himanshu. Just have a look at that. But yes, you'll find all kinds of people, Himanshu, on the dating website. So it is really like, it's a chance. It's a really a chance if you end up finding someone. So I still think we should go the conventional way. I'm an old schooler here. I believe in having a conversation, pick up the phone call and talk. Meet, physical presence really is like a moment of truth, and you really understand whether you're physically vibing with someone or you're not. So even if you are on a dating website, try to get the lady out from the dating website into the real life, and that is your moment of truth. So, but that is a litmus test that you will have to like endure, and so will she. So, and it's always on from there. So Ayushi is saying, is replying to Himanshu that yeah, she met a guy on a dating site and they have planned to get married this year. So yes, so see, that is the answer to my question. Well, that, you know, it's happening to people as well. So you do find like all kinds of people, like I said. Sure, you can come. Yeah, Nikki, please come. You can come. No, it's fine, whatever, just come. Fine, okay. Ankit has joined. Kushtab, hi, how are you? Nice to see you again. Sumit Sharma says, Ayushi, take me in your company. I want to join you guys. Blaze denied to take me. Where did Blaze deny to take you, man? Shishank Bani says, hi. Faiz Ahmed, cash on delivery ka facility hai kya? Ye koi product hai kya? Cash on delivery. Amazon se kuch mangwao, cash on delivery. Cash payment ki baat kar rahe kya hotel pe? So no, that is not allowed. I mean, you have to pay online. Okay, so we don't have any cash facility. Himanshu says, conventional way, oh come on man, there are still some guys who don't even have guts to say excuse me. Okay, so you don't have the guts to say excuse me to a girl. Arre yaar. Okay, I have a solution for that as well. I have taken out a course, a dating course, where I tell people how to make conversations to a woman. So I will post that link to you as well. That's not the Bible, but that will just give you a slight direction on how you can sort of get your way around with women. So listen man, don't underestimate yourself so much. Take a risk. Kya hoga zyada se zyada bolegi get lost. Chala jana. Kya hoga zyada se zyada bolegi please don't bother me. Don't bother. But at least you won't have this regret ki I didn't say hi. So say hi man, please. Daro mat yaar. Crush doesn't reply, what do I do? If your crush doesn't reply, my friend, kon bola ye? Sushant, if your crush doesn't reply, then please move on. Because obviously she doesn't want to talk to you, or she doesn't want anything to move forward. So just move on. There are more people out there. Ek hi crush nahi hogi puri life mein. Just like keep moving forward, keep looking forward. To all the guys, I really want to say this, as a woman, please keep your dignity and please maintain your self-respect. If a woman is not responding to you, like, unless she's really worth it, like, really worth it, ki tumhe lagega bas chahe mana bhi kar de, but mujhe try karna hai. Unless she's that sort of worth it, back the fuck off, man. You don't need to put your self-respect on the line, because I will, you know, tell you, women are no less drama these days. Women also do tons of drama, so you don't need to put up with that ridiculous feminist nonsensical bullshit. So if your woman doesn't reply to you, if your crush is not replying to you, then just back off, man. Just, you know, no need to, like, I mean, this is 2018, yeah, who the fuck chases anyone? Nobody chases anyone these days. Like, just keep move on, man. Let's see, who's saying? Shiva Shiva saying, great work, keep continuing, Auntie and Uncle. Thank you, Shiva Shiva. Dhanyavaad. Okay. Arriba. Sumit Sharma is saying, my God, I'm. One second. Okay. Sumit Sharma is saying, we had a great conversation. He shared his contact too. I wanted to work for hotels you collaborate with as a quality. You change offer is way too good, but still needs to change this. I'm hotelier too. So, Sumit Sharma, the thing is that as in when the requirement comes up, we get in touch with people. So, since you have already shared your details with this, anytime he needs your services or anytime he needs like any sort of services or expertise from you, he will get in touch with you. So, your details will be there with them, or we keep all the details of the people who are with us, and you know, don't worry about it. Someone will get in touch with you when it is needed. Himanshu saying, "Zyada se zyada papa ko bula sakti hai madam, phir wo baat jo bahut bari padega. Papa ko bhi kya bulayegi? Itna kahan time hai yaar kisi ke paas, Himanshu. Screw it, man. Get it." So Shant is saying, what should I do? Move on? I hope it was this easy. Oh, Sushant, I understand. It's not easy to move on when you like have feelings for someone. But if she's not responding to you, then you know, that's a reality you need to accept. If she's not responding to you, then she probably doesn't want anything going on with you. And it takes time, I understand, to move on. You know. I mean, it's not easy. I completely get this. You know, I've been through heartbreaks, major heartbreaks, you know, as well, if you ask. But it happens. You move on. You'll find somebody else who you know, who will not fill the void, but you'll find somebody else who you will have better connection with, who you'll have better meaning with, and someone who respects your worth, you know, someone who respects you and accepts you as who you are. So, if she doesn't, if she's not responding to you, then, you know, just keep your dignity and don't lose your sense of self-worth. You are worth much more, man. You are worth a response. You are worth a response, you know. So, if she's not responding to you, then you will find someone who will respond to you, who will respect you, and who will find your, you know, who will give her your time. You know, so just have faith and just you know, keep it cool. If you want to speak to me further on this, you can just email me. I'll put my email address as well, and I will respond to you if you need more help. I have another link that can help you when it comes to, you know, how to move on from someone. You know, 10 things you can do to sort of move on. So maybe that can help. Okay, I have some more questions here to ask. Okay. My partner is pressurizing for marriage and I'm not ready. So, this is a guy who is saying that my partner is pressurizing for marriage. We've been on for 2 years and I just think that we can go on further. I am only 27. Yes. Good question. To be honest, guys, my personal opinion on this is always that men should generally marry after they are 30. Getting married before 30 is just, in this day and age, it is foolish. It's foolish to get married before 20, before like 30, because I feel that it takes a while for a guy, for a male, for a man to come to that point where he can give himself exclusively to a woman. And I'm talking about reality. So, I would not expect any of you guys to say, but it's okay for a guy to be exclusive. The fact is that it's very difficult for a guy to be exclusive to a woman before he's 30. And I have seen many cases where, you know, I had someone, you know, like some people I know who got married at the age of 27. And 3 years down the line, now they're like, I'm wondering if I did the correct thing, because now I miss my single life and I miss my bachelor days. And you know, a couple of my friends have come and told me this, and not just friends, but like people I talk to on a regular basis. So if you are not ready, my friend, you have to express to her, because you know, women in our country are groomed to get married. Bachpan se yehi bola jata hai, ye to paraya dhan hai. You know, ye to, you know, iski to shaadi hi honi hai, isko to ghar se jana hi hai, to usko paraya likhaya jata hai, usko groom kiya jata hai taki usko acha pati milega. Fir baad mein kuch alag karti hai to bolte hai, are tumse shaadi kaun karega. So basically everything that a woman is designed to do in her life is to get married. So women are groomed in such a way that she knows, acha ab 25 saal ki hogi, I will get married at 25, then I'll have kids at 28, then I'll have the second kid at 30, and then you know, my life is sorted. Like, this is how they think. But men, on the other hand, are not brought up in this manner ki tumhari 25 ki umar mein shaadi hogi. Aadmiyon se kuch bola nahi jata hai. So please express yourself. Two people have to get married together. Do not be coerced into being married. Marriage is not a joke. It is the it's when actually shit gets real. And 6 months is great for the first 6 marriage. After that, responsibilities come up and things get very different. I hope this sorts out your question. Let's see, more questions. Swapnil is saying hi. Hi Swapnil, how are you? Nice to see you again, man. Okay. Oh. Madam, let me tell you, aise to main londa sakht hu, but self respect wali baat pe main pigal gaya. Yaar nahi, I think all men should have a certain, like, they should keep like a certain amount of self respect, man. To acha hai, chalo meri baat kuch to asar hua. Piyush is saying, why there are just few viewers? It's okay, man. This live feed is going to be here on the Facebook page. Whoever wants to come, they come. And he's saying, your Wi-Fi is not working properly, so much lag. I'm so sorry, Piyush, if there is lag in the Wi-Fi. I don't know. I hope it is something we can fix. Himachal is saying, could you please repeat those words that men should not get married? Men should get married after 30. Just record it and mail it to my parents. Unko samjhao. Yaar, please guys, take this as a, this is a really fact of life. I'm saying that another thing that I really want to say this is, because it's always better if you guys, you know, like date, like what happens by 30s and you've dated a number of women. You've been with a couple of women, you've had a couple of heartbreaks, you've experienced great highs and great lows, and it sort of brings in maturity, you know, like by the age of 31, 32, you feel like, I've done this, I've done that, and now I just want to like come back to someone who knows how, you know, I like my chai at the end of the day. Like, there's some amount of, you know, predictability that you're sort of looking for. So wo ek cheez aa rahi hai, you know, after 30, thoda sa, then you naturally feel like you just want to sort of cool the fuck down, you know, and settle down. Oh, ye cheez, agar yehi circle of life agar tumne miss kar diya from your 22 to 29, then what happens is, men who have missed out on these experiences seek this experience after they get married, because naturally they have missed out on what they should have done at that time. What they should have done at that time, they have not done. So they try to do it after they get married, which is not fair on the woman, because if the woman is giving 100%, then you know, it's like not fair on her. And this is the same thing I would tell for women as well. Please do not get married because mummy ne bola ki shaadi karni hai, 25 saal ki umar mein bachche karne hain, matlab isliye shaadi nahi karni chahiye. You have to get married because you think that you want to settle down with someone, you know. Padhai kar lo, apne dreams pehle pure kar lo, you know, do what you have to do in your bucket list, and then finally come down, you know, going exclusive with one guy. This is something I would tell both of them, really specifically to the men as well. What is that age in which a girl should get married, Ayushi is saying, if she is working? Sweetheart, I think for a woman, 28, 29 is a really good age to get married, because you have gained a certain amount of experience in your life. Maybe your job is such that you have traveled, you've got the exposure of meeting all sorts of people. Ek sense of maturity bhi aa jati hai, how to conduct yourself in certain situations, how do you conduct yourself in family situations. By age also that maturity comes. When you're working also, save up a little money for your own self as well. Thoda investments kar lo, you know, some bonds and shares or FDs or whatever you have to do. Just don't be a woman who is earning but has no savings. So job pakar li, iska matlab ye nahi ki chalo ab shaadi karo. You have to earn some money, save some money, and then think about getting married. I don't know, man. Marriage is like such an, people have such an obsession in this country ki shaadi, shaadi, shaadi sab kuch hai. But this is what I try to tell everyone, that marriage is not your life. Marriage is not your life. It is just a part of your life. It's just another dot in the timeline, like everything else, like your education, like your graduation, like your schooling, and then there's marriage. But your timeline is your timeline. Your marriage is not your life. So please remember that. That is something that I've been trying to tell everybody. Well, if you both think you are ready, then you should get married, Ayushi. Yes, correct. I'm asking in general, Manchu, in case of other arranged or love marriage. Yeah, so when you both think you are ready, mentally, emotionally, physically, financially as well, then you should get married. Financially, मैं इसलिए चार बारी बोला है, because financially, you know, finances and money is something that really breaks the glass, you know, the red honeymoon glass, and brings, you know, things down to reality. So my suggestion is both of you should be financially prepared before you take that step. And the same implies for women as well. Exactly. There should not be any differences then, according to. Please open a branch in Ranchi. Are Ganesh, Gangesh Mishra ji, zarur, zarur. A lot of, couple of more places will be added soon. Okay, Aishi saying, what should we do when career and husband has the same importance in life? To ek baat batao, why do you need to choose between the two? Why do you need to choose between your career and your husband? You both can do the same. Yes, maybe when children come, and if you don't have any support, maybe you don't have grandparents, or you don't have a long line of ayahs to look after the children, then maybe that's the time you need to take a back seat. But you should never be in a point where you have to choose between your husband and your job. If your husband is making you choose between your between each other, then that's like choose between either my mom or my dad. Like, why? Work, man. Be independent. You have your self-confidence. You earn yourself. I'll tell you something, a very big reality, Ayushi. It's not necessary that this might happen to all women. But I'll tell you something. Money and earning money for a woman should be the most, one of the most important things in her life. Because kabhi na kabhi, kisi na kisi time pe, koi na koi tumhari husband ki side ke family se koi bol dega ek din ki ye to kama nahi rahi hai. Or someone will show that lack of respect. It's a reality, I'm telling you. So at any given point of time, as much as you can, until aise hi circumstances aa jate hain ki tum chhodna pad raha job, do not leave your job. Keep earning. Please be independent. Please have your circle of friends. Please have your social life. Please give yourself space from your husband, and give your husband also space. Sara time husband se cheb rehna bhi achhi baat nahi hai. You know, and I would say the same for the husband as well, for the guys as well. Please don't stick to your wife's ass all the time. Give her space, give her freedom. Give each other space and freedom. Be independent, earn yourself, you know, make money, and, you know, travel together. Make a beautiful house, you know, I don't know, get a studio. Like, you know, do stuff together with that money. So please don't, like, this is very old school, like, conversation. What do you think a girl is expecting on the first date? Arre wah. So iske liye bhi maine ek video banaya hai. So wo bhi main tumhe post karungi, but because we have asked here. On a first date, a woman is expecting you to just be yourself. A woman is expecting this to be a normal, breezy, light conversation. A woman is expecting laughter and just sharing of experiences and good food. मैं होती तो मेरे लिए खाना तो सबसे number one importance होता है. खाना अच्छा होना चाहिए, जहाँ मर्जी ले जाओ. You know, so if your husband truly loves you, he will respect your job and career. Yes, yes, yes. Finally, someone said it. If husband don't want a wife to work, if a husband doesn't want a wife to work, he, madam, I've become quiet at this question. If a husband doesn't want wife to work, he's an ass. If he doesn't want his wife to work, then he is regressive in his thinking, and he probably just wants to control you, and he will not give you the same respect as he holds for himself as a member of the family, as an equal partner in the family, because whether you like it or you don't, love is in its one place, respect is in its one place. The two of them go hand in hand. If love falls away, the relationship falls. If respect falls away, the relationship definitely falls. So if your man is, or if you know someone whose guy is behaving like this, then you need to knock some sense in their head that this is not correct. Ma'am, please share it. We guys want those links. Yes, yes, Shivam, sorry, Himanshu, I will share all of these links right here on the comment section over here, and you guys can just check those out. I have some more time. I have 5 more minutes, that's it, and I'll take like another question. My partner body shames me. I'm on the heavier side, and I'm beginning to think whether I'm really worthy of love. This is the saddest thing ever, when you know people body shame each other, when partners body shame each other. It is something that I went through as well, to be very honest, at some point. And when you are in that situation, you think that okay, I will change, I will work out, I will do things. Now, two things there are. It is always good to be fit, and it's always good to be healthy and eat healthy, but that is not something you should do for somebody else. That is something that you should do for yourself. No one has the right to come and body shame you, because today they are thin, tomorrow they might just become fat. Who knows? And this body is not going to remain like this. We're all going to get wrinkles and all going to get die. You know, we're all going to be dead. You know, we're all going to have loose skin. Women will have loose skin here and other places, which I don't want to mention. But if your guy is body shaming you, you need to turn to the other direction and walk and tell him to get lost. And nobody has a right to put you down. No one has a right to, you know, make you feel bad about yourself. It is different when you encourage someone to be fit, but the way to that is not to shame them. The way to that is not to make them feel bad about themselves. The way to that is to nurture them and to encourage them. And perhaps if you want someone to be fit, you can do that regime with them. You know, do it together. Encourage them, you know. But if somebody is body shaming you, and this goes for the guys as well, guys, if your woman is body shaming you, or if she's comparing you with other guy who's so hot or who's so good looking and he's got these fat abs, you know, then tell her to walk. Say, hey man, this is me, this is who I am, accept me as the way I am. Whether I'll work out or not is my deal and it'll be for myself, but I'll never do it just because, you know, you find me whatever. So please turn the other direction and walk. Ma'am, what about the food? The girl has chosen the venue for tutti, right? No, man, please. You guys can both share the venue together. That is not such a big deal. Okay. And the last question I will take for this evening is that my partner doesn't introduce me to her friends. What is going on? We've been dating for 6 months. And by now, well, like, I have introduced her to my friends, but she hasn't. So 6 months is a long time, man. normally people end up introducing their boyfriend girlfriends in like a span of weeks. But if 6 months have gone by, then you need to ask her this question, because obviously if she's not introducing you, there are two things. She's afraid of something, she's afraid of some public image, or she's embarrassed by you, or she's guilty about something. So you need to talk to her directly face to face and tell her. And my way of, you know, resolving issues is not to, you know, fight. Don't fight, don't accuse, don't blame. Just put the issue out there. That this is the issue and this is what I'm observing, and please tell me what is going on. So I think the easiest way to do is to just communicate with her on the face, express yourself. I always tell people, please express yourself, please express yourself, please express yourself, because that's where, like, if you don't express yourself, you're not doing justice to yourself, you're not doing justice to the other person or the relationship. So ask her straight away that I've introduced you to all my friends and I don't understand why you're not introducing me. Is there an issue? Is there something about me that's bothering you, or something about this relationship? Or do you have some issue on your own that maybe we can solve together? So what is it? That's what my suggestion to you would be, my friend. Because normally people are very excited to share that they've met someone in their life that they're excited with. And if she hasn't introduced, then all sorts of alarm bells should be ringing in your head. Okay, so back to my updates. The new website is on. Please check it out. Some little bit snags and glitches are happening because we have just launched it. So we sort of, sorting things out as and when they come. But just give us some time, few more days, and everything will be smooth as butter. Please download the app from the Play Store and the App Store. Also, guys, do you know that we have a StayUncle forum? It's a relationship forum where people can register and log in anonymously with their nicknames, and they all share their problems on this forum. And all of us are here to answer the questions. We will not know your identities. Nobody else will. So you can feel free and ask questions. We have people who ask about, you know, their relationships. Sometimes they ask about their work problems. Sometimes people ask about their sex problems. Some people share their fantasies. Some people, you know, share their marital problems. You know, someone's best friend is doing something and they want help. So you can come to the forum. I will post the link to that as well. I have a lot of links to post today. So please come on the forum as well. Have a look, register, log in. I'll be there. StayUncle is there. All of us are there to answer your questions. I will post my email address as well in case some of you want to have a slightly more detailed conversation with me about your relationship, or you have some problem, or you want me to take up some more things. I will. 9th of February is going to be very interesting, guys. Make sure you are there on 9th of February. I have a beautiful surprise and you are just going to love it. I have just finalized on the plans today. Well, almost 90% plan is done. And that feed is something that I'm really looking forward to. So, all right, it's about 5:49. My God, this feed is generally longer than it should. Himanshu saying bye. Have to leave. I'll use your tips for my first date. Fingers crossed. Thank you, Himanshu. Devi Prasanna says thank you, StayUncle. Big hug to you all out there. Thank you. Hugs for me too. Okay, guys are thanking Ayushi and Himanshu are thanking each other. Great. All right, guys, I will see you again next Friday with my lovely, wonderful surprise. I have a guest coming that day, by the way. Thank you, guys, for joining this feed and asking me your questions. I'll be posting my link soon, and I will see you again next week. Till then, bye. Have a good weekend.